What's up, guys? Andrew Cruzy here, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to easily connect Airtable to Go High Level with a button. So if you have a contact in Airtable, you can easily go to their Go High Level contact. I'm going to do that in under 10 minutes. It's going to be jam-packed really fast to get you the value, and we're just going to hop into it. So first things first, identify where they're coming from. So we have contacts coming in from Go High Level based on leads. We have our leads OS up here, boom. And then we have contacts coming in from booking sales calls and triage calls and all of that, right? The example I'm gonna show you is the one on sales calls, but you can also use this for your leads, for your team members to easily find their contacts, to call them, to email them super easily. And the button is just right there. So let me show you how to set it up right here. The very first thing is identify where they're going to come from. Here we have people signing up for sales calls here. And I'm going to show you this example and then show you the Zapier automation. So Andrew Cruzy, we're just filling out this form. And let's do this, andrew@gmail.com. And then I'm not going to put in my real number right now, but here we go, 555-55555. Hopefully that's good enough. And then put in this, and all of this data will come over as well. My offer is sweet. Boom. What's the biggest bottleneck? Do you agree? Yes, I agree to show up to the call. And then we have a pre-call video after we book here. So what this is doing after I hit schedule meeting, boom. And hopefully that will go across. Let me click it again. Cool. I just needed to change the phone number because I did the 555, but boom. Then we have the pre-call video right here. That's really good. If you're a coach, if you're an agency owner, pre-call video, warm them up. And you'll see higher show rates. You'll see better conversion rates. If you're not doing this, check out the links down below and we can help you out with that. but what that is doing is it is taking it from a form over to Zapier. So here's the very first step that you want to do inside of Go High Level here. So let me pause this so it doesn't interfere with the contacts and the phone numbers and emails and I don't get shut down. But this is powerful. First thing you want to do is set up this webhook here inside of Go High Level. So you create a new workflow and then it will open up something like this, but it will be blank. And the trigger is going to be the form that they filled out. Here are our sales call forms. So form submitted, form is, and you put those forms in, right? So make sure you have a form set up on Go High Level if they're booking in that call. If you want me to do an additional video on how to get the leads into Airtable, hashtag leads down below in the comments. And if we get enough, I'll do that video as well. But you do the trigger, form submitted, the sales call forms. And then you do a webhook. So you hit the plus button, webhook right here, perfect. And you wanna grab the webhook from Zapier. So it should be webhook post hook zapier.com and you're gonna hit save. So where do we get that webhook? Well, you go into Zapier, you create a new flow in Zapier. So go to Zapier right now and you click on webhooks for Zapier. And after the setup, which the event is catch hooks, so put that in right now. And then you go to configure, you copy this one, boom, and then test. So after you put it into Go High Level here, boom, you hit save, you hit publish up here, and then you can test that on Zapier. So what that will do is that's connecting Go High Level with now Airtable. So your second step inside of this automation, boom, is setting up Airtable. So you want to make sure you have the right columns set up in Airtable. We have the name, the call booking date, the phone number, the offers, what they filled out on their form, their bottleneck, their revenue, their targets, all that stuff, all that data for the sales team, right? But here is the key. You wanna have one column in Airtable, put this into your Airtable right now that says GHL contact ID. That is crucial. And then you map the contact ID from Go High Level to Airtable there, right? Just the contact ID. That's the one thing you don't want to miss to create this button, the GHL contact ID, and map it there. So that's what this looks like here. Boom. And it goes into the Airtable. And from there, since I filled out this form, boom, I showed up there. Beautiful. And what I can do now, since the contact ID is mapped over here, boom, I can click open GHL and it will go straight to my GHL contact. Sweet. So I can text, I can email. Everything is nice and sorted inside of, boom, inside of Airtable there. But that's not it. I got to show you how to set this up. So inside of here, on the data side of things, let me go into that. Boom. Edit. Here are the formulas that you need. So here, we're going to go into this. And the first thing that you need is that column with the Go High Level. Boom. And I'll show you a full breakdown of how to set this up. Go High Level ID. And here are the formulas. So you have that column with the Go High Level ID. And then you want to create a button function with your Go High Level ID and the Go High Level contact ID. So you have this Go High Level location. This is crucial. You want to take this and the location ID, you want to swap out with your Go High Level location ID. And you can easily find that by going into Go High Level, going into contacts, and this string of letters is your ID location. So basically you can just copy all of this up to details. Boom, copy that. And then put that inside of this right here. So you want to do a quotation mark, that link, and boom, the GHL contact ID. So you might want to pause here, put that in, and make sure that's a column inside of your Airtable. If you're doing this from scratch, Airtable is really easy to use. We basically use it to systemize our entire business, my finances, my relationship with my girlfriend, my own self-mastery, all of that. It's pretty cool. If you're just getting started, hit the create button right here, start from scratch, and then go into the table and create a new table for sales calls. Boom. Boom. And put the name there, boom, contact ID, and use a URL for that, boom. And then let's say sales rep and user, boom. And you can connect that through the Zapier automation as well, but let's just use, boom, and then date, call date. Perfect. Sweet. And then we want to create this button right here. So let me show you how to create this button. Button. And what I'm going to do is go to this, grab this, boom, go here. And put quotation marks in. Perfect. And contact ID. Sweet. And then I'm going to go up here. And through the Zapier automation, this will automatically pull over. Boom. And Andrew Cruzy, let's say, Maiko's taking the call on the 27th. Boom. And then I can hit that button. And that will go straight to, fingers crossed, the contact inside of Go High Level. So I can text out, I can email out, all of that stuff. So that's about it for this video. I hope that was under 10 minutes. Let me see. It was 10 minutes on the dot. Let's go. If you want to learn more, we have our school community down below. If you want to go faster together, there's a book call link down below as well. And hit that heart button, hit that like button. The more engagement we get, the more people we can reach, more people we can help. If you want me to do an additional video on getting leads into Airtable with this button as well, I'm happy to do that. I'll talk to you guys soon.